Hey, so let's have a summary of what we've learned so far from the electric charges, electric forces, and electric potential and electric potential energy. Okay, so we know that if there is two charges, okay, and the distance between these two charges is known to be R, we learned that there is a force between them. So this would be Q1 and this would be Q2. Coulomb came and identified exactly what that force was, and he said it's equal to K Q1 times Q2 divided by the distance between them squared. So that was the value of that force. Now, this force could be a repulsion force or attraction force, depending on the types of charges. If one of the two charges are positive, it's going to be a repulsive force. If the two charges are negative, it's going to be also a repulsive force. If one of them is positive and the other one is negative, it's going to be an attraction force. If you are asked to find the force acting on this charge, for example, because of the presence of the other charge, then your object of interest must be this charge. Okay? So you kind of like try to see what the force is going to be, repulsive or attraction. If these are positive, so the force direction will be this way. Okay? So this is the force direction if both of them are positive or both of them are negative. But if this one, for example, is negative charge and is acting on this one that is positive charge, then the direction of the force will be this way, if that makes sense. Okay, now once you plug in the numbers for these two charges, whether they are positive or negative, in the equation, you just plug in the value of these charges, the value. You don't care about the sign because you already took care of the direction. So once you find the answer, whatever that answer is in Newton, you probably have to indicate the direction with the angle, with the positive x-axis, or whatever the direction is, so that would be the force. So you took care of the signs when you took care of the direction. Now, this charge felt the force coming from this charge because this charge here spits out electric field lines, and electric field lines influences other charges. And the definition of the electric field is simply equal to the force acting on any charge, let's call it Q0. Okay, so I just want to let you know that the electric field, since it's coming from force, and force is a vector quantity, so both of these are vectors. So remember that very well. And that's why we indicate the direction. And we can write the electric field in another way. Electric field, since it's force over Q0, so divide this quantity by Q, you get K Q over R squared. All right, now let's go to the other side. And this other side, we have potential energy, okay, and it's electrical potential energy. And the electric potential energy of between two charges, we called it W, and we called it was equal to K Q1 times Q2 divided by R. This is a scalar quantity. What that means is that when you plug in the value of the charge here, and it has a sign that is negative, you also plug in the sign. All right? Now, the nice thing about scalar quantity is that you don't have to worry about the direction at all. At all. So that's the nice thing, and it's actually much easier. Another quantity we calculated is the delta V, the potential difference of a point charge between two points. So that would be KQ 1 over R 2 minus 1 over R1. And finally, the potential of one point charge is KQ over R. And this is also a scalar quantity, meaning that you have to put the sign if there is a sign here. If you have three point charges, then the potential of these three point charges at a point R, or different distances for three point charges, then you have to add three terms for each charge. So these are scalars, these are vectors, and I hope this summary helps in understanding the past material. Thank you very much. Goodbye.